speeches generally consist of four parts: three minutes, R major, commutator, and brush. Field magnet consists of yoke, pole, core, pole shoe, and magnetic coils. These are the major parts of DC machines. This is yoke. In small machines, cast iron yoke are used because of cheapness, but in case of large machines, it is made of fabricated steel due to its high permeability. This is pole shoe. It supports the field winding, that is the field windings, and speed over flux around the armature periphery uniform. Now this is the armature. It's the rotating part of the DC machine. It consists of coil of insulated wires. Around an iron as a manner that the electric current are induced in this wire, particular wire, when armature is rotated in the magnetic fields. This is the commutator. It's made by copper. And this is the commutator segments. These segments are insulated by mica. This is brass, generally made by graphite or carbon graphite because of self-lubricating property. Now, symbol we are used here, phi for the flux per pole, its unit is Weber, P is the number of pole, J is the total number of active conductor, E is the number of parallel path in armature winding. In case of DC machines, if it is lap wound, the parallel path is always equal to number of pole, and in case of wave winding, parallel path is always equal to 2. Here, small e is denoted as the rotation of armature in RPM. Omega m is the speed radian per second. Now, the excitations, that is, there is mainly two methods of excitation. One is separately excitations, and another is self excitation. In case of separately excited system, field winding consists of several numbers of turns of winding wire and connected external DC source. Okay, the voltage of external DC source has no relations with the armature voltage. Now, in case of self-excitation system, there's three parts. One is the series excitations, another is shunt excitations, another is compound excitations. Self excitations means when the field winding is excited by its own armature, field must have some residual magnetism. So when the armature is rotated, the residual voltage appears across the armature terminal. Now, series excitations, field winding consists few number of thick wire and connected it measures. So it is a current operated field. Now this is the sand excitations. Field learning consists large number of fine wire and connected in parallel with the armatures. Voltage across the armature terminal, that is the zone, are shaped with the voltage across the field. So it is the voltage operated field. Now the compound excitations. If the machines have both sea and sand excitation, that means it called the compound excitations. If the field flux, that is sea field flux and sand field flux, add each other, that means the resultant flux increased, the machine is called the cumulative compound. Again, if the series field and sand field opposes each other, the resultant field flux is increased, that called the differential compound machines. Another, that the long shunt as per the construction and short shunt. Now the EMF equations for machines. For people machines, suppose we consider people machines, number of pole is P and flux per pole is 5 Wb. So total flux cuts by one armature conductor in one revolutions is P into 5. With this N regulations, this N regulations per second, time required for cutting the total flux P5, that is for one regulations, 1 by N second, average EMF induced in one conductor is equal to total flux cut by the conductor divided by time required to cut the total flux, that is I divided by 1 by N, that is P in 5. Now for total armature conductor shield, that is shield by E conductor series between two brasses. So brass voltage or total induced EMF generated in the armature is V N5 divided by A, that is 60 RPS systems. Now simplifying these equations, that is E equals to V N5 divided by 60 A. Here this one is the constant, okay, and N by 60 written as omega M. So the equation is K phi omega M. Here omega M is the angular rotation, that is radian per second. Now the torque equations. Again we know that the power is equal to voltage into current, that is EIA, and power also equal to the torque into angular rotations. So EIA equal to T into omega M, and omega M equals to 2 pi N by 60. Okay. Now putting A, this value would be 2 pi 60. This one, EIA equals to this one. Okay. This would be equal to T into omega M. That means T equals to this again for a particular machines, number of pole, number of conductor, number of parallel path is constants. This is the mathematics value 2 5. So K A, this one is a K A, K A 5. So in case of DC machines, T equals to K 5 I A, electronic torque equals to K 5 I A. Now we are construct a DC generator. So you have to put the current directions. That means you are giving here mechanical power, armature rotate in the magnetic field. So induce EMF generated here, current IA flow through this path. Okay. Field current through this path. And here is the load current through this. So again we move that E equals to PA560A. Now applying the KVL in this loop, that gives the VL equals to A minus IARE. As it is DC shunt generator, then the voltage across the field is equal to the voltage across the terminal. So field current VL by now applying KCL in this node, that is the armature current is equal to the field current plus line current or load current. So again, this is the summary.